Good morning. I'm Sir William Masters reporting for ModMobilian.com. We're in lovely downtown Mobile, Alabama at the Blind Mule Restaurant and Bar. We're here to find out if indeed they do serve the best hamburgers in the world. I've heard they do. Blind Mule is where it's at. These are the best burgers in town, hands down. You tell your chef, best burgers. I need a cigarette. Nothing you can fix, just a bad day, world, it's cool, no big deal, it's not your problem, don't worry about it. It's all right.
Sounds like you need to take a trip down to the Paper Wasp. It's an art gallery. They've got a lot of water-based art. It's kind of the theme of the show. Get you some peace, calm,
maybe
deep breaths while you're there.
Maybe.
We'll be good for you.
We'll see. Oh, do you know where that's at?
It's at 306 Dauphin Street.
Okay, I'll check it out. Thank you, sir. I'm sorry I was rude to you.
I'm sorry.
Chester Gallery.
Paper Wasp opened in September of 2009. We're a gallery that focuses on book arts and works on paper, although we represent a full spectrum of art from ceramics to painting to sculpture, of course to works on paper again. We host 12 exhibits a year, so the space is always completely different when you walk in. 1 month it may be nothing but ceramics, the next month it may be nothing but books, and then you may come in and there's a huge multimedia exhibit or installation. We do all sorts of shows because I think it's important to keep things unexpected and fresh so people don't really know what to expect when they walk into the space. Other than that, we'll always have handmade books. That's the one constant. It makes for a lot of extra work constantly rearranging and getting artists and lining it up, but it's well worth it. It keeps the space from being too static, and I think that's really exciting. This month we have a really cool show called Water, which explores and reflects upon our proximity to water and how it informs our culture. It's particularly timely, of course, with the situation in the country, but I think that this show is whimsical, I think it's fun, I think it is summery and beachy without being too completely literal. I set out to choose four artists whose work I really thought reflected the notion of water and the coast in a way that was not trite or overworked or too touristy. And Nikki Burkett, who does wonderful block prints. There's an installation in the front window of 48 jellyfish, which are printed in varying colors. They're all for sale individually. And they're printed on wood, and I think they're just really special and very cool. I also have Yuko Jordan, who is a local ceramicist. She created water vessels and vases and containers which reflected water in the way she applied glaze, but also in the form. The next artist we're featuring in this month's exhibit is Steve Strickland. He's a professor at Faulkner State over in Bay Minette. I really like the angle that he paints from, that sort of 30-degree looking down across the beach. I think they're just really smart. People standing on the beach is a kind of theme in art along the coast that's done a lot, but these seem very different and more graphic. I like the fact that they're low color. I just think they're really cool. And lastly, we have Rebecca Webb, who is a local photographer. She lives over in Fairhope. And I first saw her photographs of jellyfish and absolutely fell in love. They're just so beautiful. They look like ink and water almost. And she has this really cool mixed media process that makes them look very translucent and ethereal.
So you mentioned these handmade books that you make here. Maybe you could show us how that works. You could make one for us right now.
It's going to take a while.
Oh, it's okay. It's the internet. We got plenty of time. So just, you know, take your time.
This is a four needle Coptic. Doesn't sew itself together very quickly.
How many of those would you have to do to finish this?
Oh, another 7.
Yeah, this. You know what? We'll just fix this in post. We'll do this in the editing process. A lot easier that way. Pretty nice. That's good. I like that. Look at this. Can you get in on this? This here? This is what he was telling us about, the stitching. What was that called again?
It's called a Coptic stitch.
Coptic stitch, right there. That's nice. Very nice. That was just what I needed. Beautiful art. Beachy, sunshiny, a little reminiscent. Little nostalgia. That was so wonderful. I think what I want to do now is I'm going to go down to Serta's and get me a cup of coffee, because they got some of the best coffee down here.